Welcome to Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiad, for the final day of action from the Fun Park Poprovolok. It is the slalom for the men today, the ninth and final medal to be decided in what has been a fantastic alpine program. And we start with the first run of the men's slalom. As always, slalom day involves two runs, the first coming up for you just now, the second later on this final day of action from Fun Park Poprovolok. And the fastest 30 from the first run will go in reverse order in the second run. It is a glorious spring day here in Fun Park Poprovolok, above freezing at the top as we look down over the city and the mighty river Yenisei that flows through the heart of Krasnoyarsk. And this first pattern of gates set by the Japan coach Hiroki Honda, 53 gates, and they will be skiing on the skier's left hand side of the run in this first leg on that set of gates. Two sets of gates up there at the moment. The second run will come down the right hand side. Well, Russia have dominated this alpine program and they will look to win their ninth medal and fourth gold. But the top 15, drawn at random, and Nikita Alekhin has got to have a very good chance here. He's been skiing very nicely. And then from 16 onwards, they will go in their order of FIS points. In total, we have 93 competitors from 35 countries taking part. Not quite as many as the men's giant slalom, where we had over 100. But just there, you saw going through the bottom of the screen, number 47 or 48, Anton Enshedevsky. Well, he skied the second quickest time in the slalom leg of the men's alpine combined to go from 30th to second. So he might be an outsider to watch out for. And as we go through the final pages of the start list, some countries you might not expect to see on the starting list of an alpine race, such as Mongolia and Tajikistan, but they are here and they are taking part. Final day of action means a final photograph for the doctors and the course crew as mementos of what has been a fantastic alpine program. Paco Hassan of France, the next to challenge. And Hassan, having seen the first two in front of him fail to finish, might just be a little wary of this pattern of gates set by Honda Hiroki of Japan. Hassan, who skied very nicely in the parallel team event. ...27.84 on that time split. And now he transitions from steep to flat, but still key these turns. We've seen athletes lose a lot of time. Predominantly, a lot of athletes have lost time. So that's at 43.32. We'll have to wait and see how competitive that is. Mix Zvezhniks from Latvia, the next to go, bib number 9. A couple of wins this season in FIS races and entry league FIS races. And Zvezhniks went nicely in the alpine combined, had the third quickest slalom time, but here, 27.84, this is a different proposition altogether, this first leg of the proper slalom. But Zvezhniks is doing nicely, 0.2 to the right side of the clock. The Latvian getting it all together here. Excellent work. Now, can he drive these final turns? This looks very dynamic from Zvezhniks. And he does increase his lead by 100.23 the right side of the clock. We have a new leader. Koyama Yoi. Second at the Youth Olympics in giant slalom, twice a winner in slalom races in the Far East Cup, the latest of which was in Korea back in February. Now Koyama will look to try and take advantage of his pattern of gait set by one of the Japanese coaches. And he looks to be going nicely here, Koyama. And the clock, 27.62. The time split is 0.41, the right side of the clock. He's got to keep this together, though, on this transition. Koyama, somehow stays on his feet, dynamic through that verticale, stops on the line. 0.34, the right side of the clock. He could have been quicker, but he'd be happy with the lead. Richard Liegeb from Austria, eight times a winner, in FIS slalom races, the last of which was in January 2018 in Austria. Part of the Austrian team that won the Parallel Nations team event. Here's the first tricky turn, and again, the outside ski being bounced around. Liegeb on full out attack mode here. Attack being the best form of defense from the Austrian, 24 years of age. Nicely done. Liegeb in good form, but he's 0.19 the wrong side of the clock. That's in touch, though. The Austrian, if he can ski quickly here, remember Koyama had an error coming off the transition from steep to flat. Liegeb driving, 42.75, 0.17 the wrong side of the clock. That is a good position to be in for a second run charge, although he looks a bit disappointed from the body language. Simon Efimov from the Russian Federation. Three top fives in slalom races this season. What can Efimov do here after the disappointment of Alekhine skiing out? Efimov, the second Russian in the top 15 seeds. And Efimov looks in control, doesn't he? Nice still upper body, legs doing the work, and it relates into the clock, but here's an error, and Efimov on the backs of his skis manages to stay in the course. Has it cost him any time? Efimov drives for the line. No, it has not. He's found another load, and he leads by 0.86. Baptiste Silvestre is out of the start hat. Now the Frenchman, 20 years of age, two podiums in slalom races during his racing career, one of which was this season. And he was third in an FIS race in February. And this is an excellent run from Silvestre. Just 0.19. No one has been anywhere close to Efimov, our leader, until this moment. Oh, is that a little error? Baptiste driving for the line. 0.24. The race is on. Efimov now has a bit of pressure on him. That is an excellent run from Baptiste Silvestre. Alexei Ovchinnikov of Russia, the next challenge. 21 years of age, a couple of slalom wins in his career, the last of which came about 14, 15 months ago in an FIS race here in Russia. Now, Ovchinnikov. .97 off the pace. Getting plenty of support from the home crowd. And Ovchinnikov goes sick, 1.31 off the pace. So what a first run we've had in the men's slalom, but it's the Russian Federation that lead the way. Simon Efimov leads by 0.24 of a second from Baptiste Silvestre of France. Koyama Yoi of Japan is third, 0.86 off the pace, but it's going to be very interesting in this second run. The top 30 going in reverse order, so Silvestre will have to try and put the pressure on Efimov in that second run. A really, really difficult opening run of the men's slalom, a high attrition rate, but a second run that is set up beautifully. Well, the 93 competitors from the first run have been whittled down to 47 in this second run from 25 countries. And remember, the fastest 30 from the first run go in reverse order. Well, Loic Lekelec from France has set this second pattern of gates, 54 in total, and I'll be fascinated to see how they fare on the third and fourth gate, which are set very, very straight down the full line. They'll be having some incredible speed, you feel, come the fifth gate. Let's see how they fare. Klinsky then gets us underway, 4.04 slower than our leader, Simon Efimov from the Russian Federation. The Russian Federation with 8 medals, leading the medal table here, but looking for their fourth gold of the Alpine program. And the quickest was Simon, but he just a little bit of pressure on him because number 29 there, Baptiste Silvestre, 0.24. Silvestre coming down bib 26, an excellent run from outside the top 30. And you just wonder whether or not that might just play on Efimov's mind as he waits at the top of the hill. 20-year-old Wakatsuki Hayata, 15th quickest after the first run, has an advantage of 0.2 of a second over Jesper Persson of Sweden, our current leader in this second run of the men's slalom. And Wakatsuki into the rhythm nicely. A mistake in the first run costing him the chance of a medal, but this is an opportunity to show us what he can do. And this is dynamic, quick slalom skiing from Wakatsuki. If he can keep it together and stay upright, this should be quick at the time split, you feel. And it is 0.47 from 0.2 to 0.47. Wakatsuki is flying here. Now can he generate pace on these bottom turns? We've seen some racers get 0.53 on these bottom turns. Wakatsuki gets 0.03 and he leads by half a second, 1:29.46, the new best time. Yannick Doblaire of Switzerland, 0.19 of a second, his advantage over Wakatsuki, our leader in the finish area. Oh, Doblaire just about makes the blue gate. And what we've seen in these runs so far, that mistakes higher up the challenge don't seem to have so much of an effect on the time because of the steepness and the slickness of the track. Racers have got away with errors up the mountain as opposed to further down the mountain. On this occasion, though, Doblaire is a quarter of a second on the wrong side of the clock, but that's gettable on these bottom turns. 0.53, the most we've seen gained on the bottom here. And Doblaire finds time, goes second, but he doesn't find enough time. Daniel Palace of the Czech Republic, nearly a third of a second in the bank over Wakatsuki. Oh, Joel Kohler, sorry, in the finish area. Kohler. My apologies, my assistant just playing up. It is Wakatsuki who is the leader. And Paulus has 0.32 of a second over him. That's now 0.22, the wrong side of the clock. So the 24-year-old Paulus needs to really drive these bottom turns. Trying to generate the space, the speed, 1:29.46. He finds just 0.02, goes third. Bib three is Paco Rassa of France. Rasa has 7/10 over Wakatsuki, our current leader. But Rasa is 1.43 seconds slower than Efimov from the Russian Federation, the leader after first run. So he has to try and find time on Wakatsuki and apply pressure to Efimov at the top of the hill. And they just look a little heavy, some of these turns, and you wonder whether or not the 7/10 will still be there. Well, it is still there, and he's found 1/100 of a second. So Rasat doing nicely on those top turns, but can he drive through these bottom turns? Rasat, 4 slalom podiums in his career, 2 this season. He finds time, and he finds 39/100 to lead by 1.1 seconds. Richard Leitgeb of Austria, a gold medalist in the parallel team event, 4th fastest after the first run. He has 0.4 in the bank over Rasa, our leader, but he was 1.03 slower than Efimov after the first run. So Leitgeb, the 24-year-old, 8 slalom wins in his career. Can he dig deep and find a super second run here at Bobrovilog? So, oh, looking dynamic, perhaps a little heavy on that left edge, but he's looking good here. Running a little late in the line, but he's still got the green light. He's found 1/200. This is good from Leitgeb. Now, can he drive on these bottom turns? Can he find the sort of time Rasa found? Rasa found 0.39, Boisse 0.53. And he loses time, but he still leads by 0.28. He loses 2/400 in those final turns. Koyama Yoi of Japan, his advantage over Leitgeb of Austria, our leader, 0.17 of a second from the first run. Koyama, the 3rd quickest after the first run, but a full second slower than Efimov in that first run. He needs to fly down here. Can he add to the advantage of 0.17? Looking a little ragged and a little heavy on some of those turns, and it relates in the clock. He's lost 6/10. Now, 0.53 is the most amount of time we've seen in this second run between the time split and the finish. So this is still on for Koyama, if he can drive out of these bottom turns. He doesn't find enough time. He finds only 900s, and that means that Leitgeb has a medal because there's only 2 remaining at the top. Baptiste Silvestre, 2nd quickest after the first run. Can he apply pressure to Simon Efimov of the Russian Federation on this second run? From a bid number of 26, so from outside the top 15 seeds, it was an excellent first run from the 20-year-old. And these are good turns from Silvestre. Silvestre just getting a little heavy on the left edge, and he's down, and he is out. Silvestre is out. Rasa will pick up a medal. Simon Efimov of the Russian Federation, his advantage from the first run, 1.03 seconds. You would think this is a formality for the Russian athlete just to stay on his feet. But you can take it too easy, you can come up with a mistake, but he will look very relaxed between runs, chilling out in the athlete zone, listening to his iPad. And he loses a chunk of time, but he's got so much in the bank, he just has to stand upright. Efimov to give Russia their 4th gold medal, 128.08, comfortable 0.94 for Simon Efimov of the Russian Federation, and he takes gold in the men's slalom. Well, that concludes the Alpine programme at the 29th Winter Universiade, and Simon Efimov of the Russian Federation takes the 9th and final gold medal, 127.14 his time. Richard Leitgeb of Austria the silver, Paco Rassat of France taking the bronze. So now we will have the flower ceremony for the men's slalom, the final flower ceremony of Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiad.
Third place, representing France, Paco Rassat.
Paco Rassat of France wins France's first individual medal in the men's competition, their second overall. After Aro picked one up, a bronze in the Alpine combined. Congratulations to Rassat.
Second place, representing Austria, Richard Leitgeb.
Richard Leitgeb wins Austria's first medal in the men's skiing to go with the three golds and the silvers picked up in the ladies' side of things. Congratulations to him.
Representing Russian Federation, Semyon Yefimov!
And Semyon Yefimov of the Russian Federation wins Russia's fourth gold of the Winter Alpine Programme. Their ninth overall, they topped the medal table here at Bumpart Bobrovilov, and Yefimov set up that gold with the first run, an epic first run, and he brought it home in run two. Congratulations to Semyon Yefimov, Richard Leitgeb and Paco Rassat, our medalists in the final event here at Krasnoyarsk 2019, the men's slalom. Well, that concludes the Alpine programme from Fanpar Bobrovilov and Krasnoyarsk 2019. The 29th Winter Universiad has delivered some epic skiing. Russia topped the medal table in the Alpine skiing and they win the final event. We hope you've enjoyed the action.